tonight, by the mercies of God, we have him whom God has used for over the years to be a blessing. For the second time in UCG, we have, can we stand to our feet as we receive the ministry of Frank Edwards? Shout hallelujah. Please, can you clap? Keep clapping, keep clapping, keep clapping, keep clapping.
Good. Hallelujah. Just wave those hands to Jesus. Give him all the praise. Give him all the praise. Wave your hands. Are you tired? Then wave those hands to Jesus. Say, Lord, you alone are worthy to be praised. There is none like him. There is none like our God. There is none like our God. Wave your hands to Jesus.
Tell him,
you are
Lord,
I am.
Everybody sing. Lift your voice to Jesus. For the great amount of things.
For the great amount of things that you have done.
Lift up your voice. I reckon it.
I reckon it. Yeah.
Thank you.
Of you. is a place you get to in worship when you understand that worship is beyond the music. It's beyond the music. It's beyond the sound you heard. It's the condition of your heart. It is a lifestyle. It's a lifestyle. So when you lift up your hands and you begin to release your worship to God in whatever language, it could be in any sound. Sometimes words will fail you. There's a point you get to in worship, words will not be enough. I've been there a couple of times. And you just be groaning from the inside. You get what I'm saying? So when you're here, I love that. You know, the lights are beautiful. The sound is beautiful. I dress nice, you dress nice. But when you get deep in worship, none of those things will matter. None of it will matter to you. There's a song I would have done if Don Moen was here. He was supposed to be here. The man of God really wanted him to be here. But due to some, you know, he didn't come. In fact, it was after we had already concluded that we now plan that he's coming to Nigeria this year. But we had already concluded. But next year, I'm sure. You know, this is a worshiping church. I can sense it in the spirit. There's some places where they invite you. You go once, they invite you again, you say no. At my level, I'm no longer looking for where to go and sing. I only go again where I sense the spirit of God is. I only go again when I sense the presence of God. If I don't sense it, no matter what you pay, no matter your arrangement, you will not see me. I'm no longer looking for food now. You know, man of God, when a man does not have money, you will consider him humble. Wait until they have money. That's when you will know if they are humble or if money is the driving force for what you're doing or not. Are you hearing what I'm telling you? Worship is the lifestyle of a believer. That is why you became the born again in the first place. To come and worship God. Not for him to do something for you. He has already. So when you hear, Ikwe Siri, Ikwe Siri, Eli Wenasi, Ikwe Siri, Ikwe Siri, Ikwe Siri, Ikwe Siri, you are so good,
you are so good, you are so good, heaven declares that you are so good,
you are so good.
Good to you. You know, let me tell you something. Let me tell you something. If worship is all about singing, I want to ask you a question. What of people who are unable to speak? How would they worship God? Are you saying they will never have an opportunity to worship God? The answer is no. So worship is, that's why the Bible said the time is coming and the time has come. When the true worshippers will worship him in spirit and in truth. Meaning whether you can talk or you can't talk, you can worship God. In spirit and in truth. So sometimes words just fail you. And you begin to worship with singing tongues. Can you speak in tongues? Do you speak in tongues in this place? You know, I see God doing great and mighty things in this place already. I see God doing great and mighty things.
Money.
Whenever I call, you are there. Whenever I pray, Lord, you hear me. I'm not alone, this I know. What can I bring to you, Lord? What the song of praise, what can I do?
Thank you.
every time I have an opportunity to stand before God's people, to hold a microphone, to worship God, to lead God's people in worship, I'm asking myself, who am I? What a privilege. What a privilege. Because if you knew me 20 years ago, if I pick up a microphone, you would ask me to drop it. But for grace. How can you explain God picks a hawker on the street? How can you explain? How can you explain it? An ordinary hawker. Take microphone to lead God's people in worship. It's a privilege. It is not my right. It's a privilege. God could have chosen anybody. I tell you, there is nothing you do in the house of God that God does not have a spare. So it's a privilege. So if you find yourself serving in the house of God, whether as a cameraman or as a keyboardist, never raise your shoulder, because it's a privilege. God has many more. So for him to choose you, it's a privilege. Something inside of me. You pull in. When you worship God, what I have learned, you know, with my relationship with Don Moen, I have learned a lot about worship. Even when you have a preset, even when you have rehearsed, when you come to the altar, leave your mind open, because the Holy Ghost will speak. Sometimes something totally different from what you have rehearsed. It's okay to have a set list, but leave your mind open for the second instruction. You know, if not for second instruction, Abraham would have killed Isaac for nothing. Leave your ears open. So if you're a music minister, you need to be one with the Holy Ghost, so that as he's speaking, you're speaking. So when I sing, "Where would I be without you?" we did not rehearse it before. It came here. So it wasn't something that we rehearsed. Where would I be without you? What would I do without you? Again and over. Lift your voice.
Where would I be without you? What would I do?
Sing it again.
Where would I be without you? What would I do without you? All that I do.
I'm not in at all without you. This life I live for you, Lord. All that I do. Something is happening in this place. Something is happening in this place. Let's sing hallelujah. Everybody sing.